Amazon account is up and running now. We are selling our formula officially. It's amazing stuff from Europe.
Made in Germany.
Sold in America.
Highest standards there are. In America, the standards haven't been updated since 1980. Super weird, like older than me. In Europe, they update safety standards basically every year. This formula is top notch, great for the stomach, great for constipation. This is a great product. If you happen to want to purchase it and join us on our journey, then grab the link in the description. If you do, and leave a review for us. Send me a screenshot at vinandstory@gmail.com of your review after you have received the product. We will put your name in a hat. Song reviews are going to come out by some of the people that have left reviews. Don't forget to send us a screenshot of your review once you get the product. Now a word from our mascot dressed as a pirate, Fuji.
Ah! It's a deal of a deal.
As promised, we have returned tonight with another stream. This is DJ Revo.
As you could see, DJ Revo, gang, gang, gang. Who Revo, is currently has the title of DJ of DJs.
He does.
That's DJ Revo, ladies and gents.
Let me check that email and see if I got a response.
I'll let you know if we have one. Okay, guys, tonight... I think the theme of, is it 1971?
Part one of 1971.
Okay, so this is 1971, part one. Now, Revo, on top of being, in my view, everything is subjective, I understand, but in my view, being our top DJ, our reigning DJ. On top of that, he's also something of a music historian.
Oh, right, yes.
Like, would you Absolutely. Agree with that, or?
I feel like he said something about going for some classes or something at some point in his many lives.
Yeah, you know how you like you go to those universities and then you have these like, you know, weird classes that people have.
Yeah.
And it's like, you know, like 3rd century African art inspired by Neo-European blood. Like, I feel like Revo could do a class on pretty much American history through the lens of...
music.
Rock and roll.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, he does really good. And usually he actually has write-ups before each song, but he's going a different route tonight. Oh, actually, excuse me. No, I'm sure he's not going a different route.
Yeah, this is 1971, part one.
Yes, but I forget he has his own board.
So oh, that's right.
here it is.
DJ Revo has his own board. See, right
I
there.
I thought it was
look,
odd.
See, he has a mass media degree and a minor in history. Exactly. Exactly. I pinned that perfectly. I'm very, very proud of myself that I was able to put that together with the big
homie.
We
knew there was something. All right.
All right, so let's go. Here's the introduction. When you're the DJ, you determine what time, you determine what song, you determine the order of the song. And a lot of times our DJs also have a certain context that they want to lay. So without further ado, here we go. Here's the context. Listen very closely.
All right. This is from our DJ Revo. Today I'm having you guys react to a select of songs from 1971. And next stream on 8/29 will be the second half of the year. Here's what's going on historically just to set the mood. This was Nixon's 3rd year in office. He starts the war on drugs this year. 60%, yeah, I know. 60% of Americans disapproved of the war in Vietnam, but anti-war protesters were being cracked down upon, most famously with the Kent State shooting the year before.
Yeah, I think we covered a song on that.
We did, yep. The 26th Amendment was passed, changing the voting age from 21 to 18. This is the year the Washington Post exposed COINTELPRO, a program where J. Edgar Hoover was using the FBI to illegally infiltrate and sabotage left-wing political organizations that had been active since at least the 50s.
Talk that shit.
Meanwhile, in the UK, Sir Edward Heath was prime minister. A big issue there was when Education Secretary Margaret Thatcher increased the age of free milk in school from 7 years to 11. They also upset you. Wait. Okay. They also upset unions with their Industrial Relations Act that was passed this year. In terms of music trends, the biggest one for this era is soft rock. As covered before, we are at the heart of where musicians are dying by overdoses. Here is country rock band CCR that you have reacted to, Fortunate Son and Bad Moon Rising. Thanks for that. By them before. This was released by Fantasy Records and hit number 7 on the U.S. charts. Rain is often thought to be a metaphor for bombs, as it was used in Bob Dylan's A Hard Rain's A Gonna Fall. If we followed this, then this song is playing on the radio to ask people if they understand the damage the bombs being dropped in Vietnam are doing. The songwriter, John Fogerty, says it's about international tensions inside the band that would eventually lead to their breakup.
Internal tensions.
I'm sorry. What did I say? Intentional?
You said international. It's like, holy shit. Sorry. This band had beef and it became international? What a band.
I'm so sorry. Sorry.
Okay, but before we do that, there's a very special video we also need to watch. This is the big homie himself receiving something from us. A lot of people want to send us stuff. Somebody sent me a mail. Hey, I want to send you something in the mail. P.O. Box 7024, Lewiston, Maine, 04240, if you want to do that. Yeah, you just put attention to Vin and Sori.
Was that the thing?
That'll do it. But here we go, guys. Check this out. Check this out. This is actually from the big homie, Revo himself, y'all.
Can you turn it a little?
Yeah.
Well, I made sure that it was in there well.
Yeah, you wrapped the hell out of that.
I actually had to wrap it with my left hand because I actually recorded the beginning. Like, getting it packaged up to send to him.
I don't know if you can see. I don't know if we can see the writing on it. DJ of DJs is what it says over there.
And even on the little guitar inside.
You put the little heart on there. What, did you write something over there?
I wrote, well, because the babies had gotten the box and they, like, tore it. So I, like, mocked our children and...
Oh. Yeah, so that was DJ Revo receiving the coveted mini guitar from us, which means that he's a DJ of DJs. Anyway.
Honestly, it was such a cute little guitar. Our kids kept wanting to play it. I was like, you can't play it.
No. Also known as Destroy It. So we were, I was like,
that's what would have happened.
I was like, do not let them touch Revo's guitar.
I know. But I believe they still got the box.
Yeah, I think they hit the box. It's signed. We signed.
We
me
did.
You signed.
Yep.
Put a little message
on it.
We put
DJ of DJs on the back of the guitar.
Yeah. Shout out to the big homie Revo, though. Really very instrumental, I think, in helping us all through this COVID situation.
Yeah.
You know, when we're all stuck at home. So shout out to the big homie Revo, DJ of DJs. All right, guys, here we go. Here we go. Song number one, Creedence Clearwater Revival. What's the name of this song now?
Have you seen the rain?
Have you seen the rain? Let's do it. Guten Nacht.
It'll rain soon.
song. They said that this is in like every Vietnam or war movie. So my stepdad, really? My stepdad was a sucker for war. He was a Marine.
Oh wow.
So maybe that's why the chorus is hitting me so much, because maybe I'm like familiar with it, but I only saw it. I'm presuming they only play it in bad sections of the movie. You know what I'm saying? Like, because this was an anti-war. This was an anti-war song. Shout out to the big homie Mojo. Mojo. Huh?
You had them do the fade?
I said, hey, I'm running out of material here, bro. I need you to give me a fade, so maybe, you know.
When I found out you were going to get a haircut, I'm like, shoot, I should have told him to do the fade. So,
yeah,
you remembered.
Yeah,
that is my liking.
I remembered that it was to your liking.
It is very much
to your liking. I've modified my physical appearance so as to appeal to your sensibilities.
Working.
What do you think?
Okay, sorry, Reveal. That was a little... I got a little distracted there for a moment. I'm back. It was such an emotional part you were talking about, too.
Yeah, I know, but that tends to happen. I can't tell you how many deep and profound things I've said over the last 5 days, dear listener, that has been completely and totally just drained of all of its gravity. It's just floating now. But go ahead. You should have done the haircut, then.
If I didn't know, if he didn't tell us what the song is about, I wouldn't have known what it was about. I would have literally thought it was about rain.
Well, I would have looked at the, I always look at the date, right? 1971. I'm like, okay, Vietnam would be in full swing.
Yeah.
But again, like, that course draws out some, I don't want to say negative emotions, but more minor, sad type feeling.
Well, yeah.
But again, like, I've never heard the song before, and to your point, I think it's just I have like an emotional memory of what
was
going on during whatever movie or whatever.
Yeah.
Which is the point of a good soundtrack, I guess. But I'll tell you what, that I was watching Woodstock. They were talking about Woodstock. The recent one on Woodstock, and they were saying that the cool thing about the first Woodstock was that it was the best time for music ever. And I'm like, of course everybody's going to say that or whatever, whatever. But I'm like, I don't know, man. Like, you know, like, okay, a song like, for example, Chop Suey. You know, that powerful chorus that just captures everybody. Like, those songs are few and far between. There's that. Like, Chop Suey is a universal song. Like, everybody, whether or not you like metal, especially the way they ended it, like, that song is... That's a classic song. Teen Spirit is a classic song, I think. Like...
Yeah.
You know, songs like this, like, I don't know. They were just very powerful. People seemed to be... It was just very challenging music. Like, that's one thing I will say. Like, I hate... Like, when people diss, like, this younger generation, millennials or whatever. We're kind of somewhere between millennials and Gen Xers or whatever. But, like, I will say, like, our generation's propensity for self-criticism is not very high. Like, we're not very good at criticizing ourselves. And when I mean that, I'm like, we can't even hear criticism of ourselves from people in our own circle, much less people outside of our circle. We're not very, very good at that. And so... There's not a lot of songs in the modern age you can write that's confronting you as a private citizen.
Yeah.
So a lot of the cultural commentary songs are about how bad the police are or how bad the government is or how bad capitalism is. And but it's always you as the sort of hero in this fiction, that you and the artist are together looking at all these horrible institutions, mm-hmm. and you and the artist are righteous. Mm-hmm. Whereas a lot of times in these songs, it's like the artist is going after you. Have you ever seen the rain? You, regular American citizen, have you ever seen the rain? Have you ever seen it happen on a sunny day? Have you ever, you know, because Vietnam is essentially a tropical country, yeah. which would mean a lot of foliage, very beautiful, and, you know, we fill the air with cordite. You know what I'm saying? Like, so to me, that's like one of the main differences, is that these guys are able to self-criticize. Like, it music like this could take off where it's like, where you're being personally challenged.
Yeah, but it doesn't have like that, it doesn't have that like preachy feel to it, or like right. that like you're getting pointed. I know he's saying you,
right?
But it feels like he's like, as a community, let's look at this.
Right.
And you feel like that, you know, you're kind of a part of something, you know. And I think that, you know, probably something that influenced it as well might have been that now we can listen to music anytime we want, whatever style we want. I mean, we get so bored with music that we can just click, 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 click till we find one we like. Mm-hmm. You know, where before you had to have a deep appreciation for each song that came on because you couldn't change it.
True.
So you had to find what you liked about them. You know, otherwise you weren't going to enjoy the experience. But also coming from, I'm not sure when the radio got introduced, but before that it was only live stuff. So, you know what I mean? Like, I don't know. I think that, you know, the invention of the internet and being able to just access everything, like, I know that I feel differently about songs now and than I did when I was a kid with my little tape recorder, hoping that the song I liked was going to come on so I could hit record.
Yeah.
You know, once you captured that song, like, it had a lot more meaning to it because you had to work so hard for it.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I mean, and that was the other thing, too, is I feel like that their songs are, like, multi-layered. So, yes, you know, in one instance, we're talking about Vietnam. Then he's talking about issues within their band. And then it really can go, like, just life in general. I think that
right.
you can look at it. The storms come. Have you ever seen the rain when it's sunny and something bad comes to you? You know, like, it's another thing that we can all relate to. So it just has, like, a lot of layers to it, which makes the song relatable to a lot more people.
Right, right, right. Because that's the other thing. It's like, if the song is true politically, then it will be true personally. Because politics is just the mindset of a collection of people at a given time. That's mm-hmm. all. That's all what people call politics is. Mm-hmm. And so, it's like, yeah, that can be. That's like one end of the spectrum. It's like, have you ever seen the rain? The other end of the spectrum could be a real positive thing, which is, every relationship has storms. Mm-hmm. And so, are you gonna just bail out and quit just because a storm is coming, because there was a calm before the storm? Mm-hmm. Do you understand that this is just life? This is how it is. Mm-hmm. You're gonna go through bumpy, stormy times. Like, have you ever seen the rain? Are you there? And a lot of times, like, there's lots of people that really haven't. You know what I'm saying? Like, yep. There was a lot of things with you where, like, you really hadn't seen real life until certain things happened. You know what I'm saying? And then it's like,
yeah.
Oh, boom, here's the reality. So yeah. I think there's that aspect of the song as well. This one is a 10 right out the gate for me.
Yeah, so it is for me as well.
And
that voice that he has,
yeah,
it's like timeless to me. Like, grimy. I understand this was back in the 70s. It has that sort of grime sound to it. Yeah, I agree. That raspy sort ofness. I don't know. I really, really enjoyed...
How long was this song? It was only...
I don't know. It really only felt like it was like 2.5 minutes, but I don't know what it was.
Yeah, let me check.
But it's, again, it's one of those songs that you could picture just like... It's just playing and you're thinking, you
yeah,
know?
Yeah, 100%. 100%.
It was released as a single, I guess.
Yeah, basically 2.5 minutes, that song. Holy
it
shit.
It literally felt like it was extremely short. Yeah.
That's really insane. That's unbelievable to me. 2 minutes and 40 seconds. It's a 10. Started off really, really strong with that one. Guys, yeah, sit back, really relax. One. We are in the midst of a mega stream, so relax.
Yeah,
we got more on the way.
Popcorn, we're going to be out. Here for a while. Sorry out.
Gone.